I'm Nicklas Brendborg, I'm 28 years old, and I am a PhD student at the University of Copenhagen and a writer as well. So my first book is called Jellyfish Age Backwards. It's on the science of longevity, meaning it's a book on what we know about why we age and how to slow down this process as much as possible. The reason it's really interesting to understand why we age is because all of the worst diseases we suffer from today, like cancers, cardiovascular diseases, dementia as well, they're all age related. So someone my age, no matter how unhealthy I live, if I smoke and I never exercise and I weigh too much, I have a very low risk of all these diseases. But once you get to say 70 or 80 years old, even if you live perfectly healthy and follow all the health guidelines, you still have a vastly, vastly higher risk of all these diseases. So if we understand how we can break the aging process, then we can postpone all of these diseases and of course also get a longer life in a healthy body. If we look right now into what's going on in aging research, we have basically made it to a point where it's possible to take all kinds of model organisms like a rat or a mouse or various kinds of fish and flies and even sometimes monkeys and dogs, and then we can prolong their lives. That means now we have made it to the point where this science needs to go into humans as the next step and hopefully prolong the life of humans, not just lab organisms. Jellyfish Age Backwards is split into three parts. The first part is about aging in nature, and it explores everything from the Greenland shark, which can live hundreds of years, to this jellyfish Turritopsis, which is the one that the book is named after. Then part two of the book is about aging research in the lab. So there's all these new exciting therapies in the work that can prolong the life of, for instance, mice and rats, that we then hope eventually we'll be able to do the same thing for humans. And then the third part of the book is about what to do while we wait for all these fantastic therapies to come to market. It's about the classic health topics such as diet, exercise, sleep, supplements. I even discuss why you want to become a blood donor if you want to live a long life, why you need to remember to floss, why loneliness is one of the worst thing that can happen to an old person if they want to stick around for a long time. And then when you get the whole of the book together, you see that it's possible to extend life way longer than we can in humans presently. We have plenty of drugs on the way that might be able to do this, and there's some interventions you can do while you wait, so you're hopefully still around when you get to that point. One of the most surprising things you can do to prolong your life is to remember to take care of your dental hygiene. So remember to brush your teeth, remember to floss. And that's because in your mouth there is a lot of microbes living, so stuff like bacteria, also other organisms. And for some reason, these microbes tend to appear all these weird places where they're not supposed to be. So Jellyfish Age Backwards refers to this jellyfish called Turritopsis, which is a certain kind of jellyfish that can go from its adult stage back to something called the polyp stage. So that would be akin to taking a butterfly and turning it into a caterpillar again. Then once you have done that, and you induce it by stressing the jellyfish a little bit, then it can grow up anew, then you can stress it again, and it goes back to a young state again, and they can just go around in this cycle. So usually it only lives a couple of months, but if you keep just stressing it and letting it grow up anew, there's no one who has found any limit to how many times you can do that. So in principle, it's an example of biological immortality. So an animal that could live forever if we keep inducing it to rejuvenate itself. I think the reason Jellyfish Age Backwards has succeeded so much internationally is that aging is something that affects literally every single person alive. So every single person would be able to keep diseases at bay for longer if we could break the aging process. And they would also be able to have a nicer life in general, because usually younger bodies are just more functional. They have less injuries and they have less decay in general.